This is Melissa, teaching artist and art therapist with Project Create. Project Create is a community-based nonprofit organization located in Washington, D.C., providing free art education and enrichment classes to children, youth, and families. Today, we are going to be creating a nature mandala, and we're outside today to do that. A mandala is just a fancy word for circle. It comes from the ancient Indian language Sanskrit. And you can often see mandalas in all different cultures and religions throughout the world. They have different patterns and different colors, and they're really interesting. So we are gonna make our own today with nature materials. So you can see mine right here. It's a really windy day. Some of the materials are starting to blow away a little bit, and that's okay. I'm not really worried about that. After you make your nature mandala, it's a wonderful thing that you can leave behind for others to enjoy and admire. So what you need for this project are just a few basic supplies. We are going to be collecting different leaves, bark, pine cones, and you can see I've started to collect a few things here in my bucket. All kinds of things that you can find outside in your own backyard or on a nature trail. You also might want to bring along a pair of scissors. Sometimes it's easier to cut things. I even have a bowl here if you want to do a tracing of a circle, and some chalk. So you can use that as well. So to get started, we're going to go ahead and walk along this path and find some more materials that we can use for our nature mandala. Over here, there's a little stream, and I'm noticing a whole field of clovers. So I'm going to pick a few clovers for the mandala we're going to make. And I would suggest being very careful about what you choose to work with. If you're not sure of what it is, probably don't pick it, because you don't want to pick up anything poisonous. Weeds are really used to work with, like dandelions, maybe little blades of grass. You also don't want to pick anybody's special flowers. So I'm out here on a nature trail, so I'm just looking along the trail for different things that we could use. And we're going to walk down the trail. Things you might consider are things that have already dried out. So this particular weed has some really pretty, it looks like they were once little flowers. So maybe we could use that for our mandala. I'll take a moment to show you some other things that I found too that are great. So maybe you find things like pine cones. I also found some of these. This is from a tree. Some kind of seed pod. Even bark is great. There are even dried leaves right here. So maybe you want to work with dried leaves. It's really up to you. So I think that's enough. Let's go back to where we started and find a place for us to create our mandala. I suggest finding a place outside. Maybe that is frequented by other people, so they can enjoy what you make as well. This path is just a little walking path behind my house. And it might be fun to surprise people with the nature mandala. So you can just work with the mandala just very naturally and organically. But if you want some kind of shape or structure to hold it in, I suggest finding like a bowl and a piece of chalk. And you can outline it, and that might help you give you some kind of boundary to work with as you create it. This is optional. Across the world and different religions and cultures, they're typically, there's a balance component to them. They work with different shapes and patterns. You don't have to do that. You can just make your own free shape, or you can make something that has a pattern. I think I'm going to go with the pattern look for this one. And I usually start from the inside. So I think I'm going to start with one of my pine cones. And then I'm going to take out all the different materials I found. And I found these little nuts. I think the squirrels were munching on these. So I think I'm going to use these, and I'm going to create a symmetrical pattern. See, I think I'll do that. I think it needs color now, so I'm going to add a little bit of green. Yellow. today. Like these little seed pod things. They almost look like little stars to me. It's fun to look at different things in nature up close because you start to see incredible patterns. There's a lot of balance in nature. And we're creating balance through making this mandala today. All symmetrical. You may just want to freestyle it. Let's see, anything else? Mandala can be really complicated with all different types of things, shapes and patterns, or maybe really simple. Maybe you don't use as many materials, or you just use the same materials. That is up to you. And I have so much more materials I can use. I can make another one. You might want to make several along a path or a sidewalk to leave for your friends, family, neighbors. I would love to hear about what you thought about this nature mandala experience today. You can take pictures and send them to me.